Oh my gosh. Akemura. Akemi Okamura. Now, for those of you who don't know what she's famous for, I'll give you a couple of roles that that she's played. Any One Piece fans out there?
Yeah!
Awesome. She plays Nami from
Also, Koyuki Risa from Lovely
Contest. Vaninha from Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. And also Theo from Porco Rosso. So there are a couple of things that she's been in. And look, I don't want to keep you guys waiting any longer than you need to be. We're already 15 minutes into it and it feels like we just started. Okay, so without any further ado, please make her feel very welcome out here. Introducing Akemi Okamura! Welcome.
She's really having fun.
A little bit, and then we're going to make sure that the other microphones are on. This music is quite nice.
Oh, that's better. Can you hear us now?
Nice. Okay. Please. Okay, we need to make sure that we have everyone on board. Now, does everyone out there speak fluent Japanese?
Yes.
Not everyone. Okay. So we might need to get a translator on board. Do we have Cassie there? Almost. Okay. I'm gonna pretend I have an earpiece in.
Can you hear me?
Okay. Definitely. Okay, yes. We've almost got her on board. We're just getting the microphones all sorted out right now for you. So, firstly, I would like to say welcome. And I hope you had a safe trip to Australia. And she's here. Okay. So yeah, welcome to Australia. I hope you had a safe trip. And I heard that you went on a tour when you got here. How was that for you? And hopefully you got to see something really nice in Australia.
It was fun. We
went to the Blue Mountains yesterday.
Wow.
What did that sound come
from? Interesting.
Is that interesting?
is it? Did you find that it was quite pretty up there?
It
was really pretty.
Yeah, it was very pretty.
Oh, good. I love the Blue Mountains, and I'm glad that you liked it as well. Have you had a chance to see any of the wildlife when you're in Australia at all yet?
I've seen them in the zoos in Japan, but not here.
And do you have a favorite animal?
I hate the spoons.
Kangaroo?
I was really hoping that you were going to say koala.
Koala!
Oh, good. Because...
We got you a little present, and this is a little koala.
I'm not sure if you guys can see it out there. It's not a drop bear. This one's a koala. It's got gum leaves in its mouth. Hopefully you don't run into any drop bears. But this one is for you, and it's a present from everyone in Sydney and Australia, because we love everything that you've done, and we're so glad that you're here.
Thank you. Thank you, Australia.
And I'm hoping also, just while we're on a quick intro here, have you tried any classic Australian food yet while you've been here?
Yesterday I had some beef at Pancakes on the Rocks.
Nice. Normally people have pancakes there, but
I was there yesterday. Why?
Have someone found me. I know we don't have Kobe beef here.
I hope you
had
breakfast there.
We're not in Kobe, but still, the Japanese food is fantastic. There's there is a Japanese food that I love, and it's called natto, I think.
Natto?
Like the fermented soybeans. And in Australia we have something that we do the same thing, a similar thing here. So what I found is if I'm in Japan, a Japanese family will bring out natto and they give it to me and then they all watch my face when I try it. And they want me to go like this. So what we do is when guests come to our country, we give them Vegemite. But we usually give them a spoon and we say, can you please try it? And it's very salty, very strong. So I'm not going to do that to you. I'll actually give you something which is a little bit more popular.
Popular?
Yes. I hope you don't have fish allergy. No, I'm kidding. Tim Tams. There we go. Nice. Everybody loves Tim Tams, and I hope that you enjoy them too. These are very popular treat for everyone here.
I really love Tim Tams.
There's one trick that you may not know yet, and what you can do is actually get a Tim Tam and you bite one corner, and then you bite the opposite corner, and then when you have like hot tea, like matcha or something, you can sip it through. People usually do it with coffee, but it's very fun. All the chocolate melts on the inside, and it's quite delicious.
やってみます.
I'm going to try it.
Good. Okay. I'm sure you guys are sick of us talking about everything except anime, right?
Just like
and manga. So, what we're going to do is we're going to jump into some questions, and these ones are going to be more related to your work. So that's why you're here, and that's why all these people are here to watch you. They want to know about you and how you feel about the things that you do. Okay, so the first question that I'm dying to know is, what inspired you to get into voice acting initially?
I didn't always want to become a seiyuu. It was like before I noticed, I just became one.
You're so lucky to fall into something so fantastic, and I really hope that you've enjoyed it as much as we've enjoyed watching and listening to everything that you have done.
Yeah, it's really fun.
Was it a big step for you? Like, were you quite young when you started, or like you're still quite young now? But like, was it when you were like in your teens or early adulthood that you started? Have you been doing it for a long time? Is what I'm asking.
Yeah, I started when I was quite young.
I think having that experience under your belt has really showed up in a lot of the work you've done, especially with One Piece. It's just, it's grown, the characters have grown so much. And we've all watched that happen, and I'm sure they've been a big part of you as well, growing, having these characters grow with you. Sure, that's a very roundabout question, but it's fantastic for us to be able to watch you grow as well with the characters. Now, you've played a character in the anime of the complex who speaks with the Kansai Ben, or like...
Kansai Ben?
Like Kansai Ben? Or Sakura Star, like, you know, Nande ne? And yosh! And stuff like this. This is basically it's a different accent, I guess you could call it. And is it difficult for you to pick up an accent which is not of your native accent? And is it hard for you to continue to do that? And do you accidentally fall into it sometimes when you're at a restaurant or somewhere else as well?
It's very difficult.
Very difficult.
The intonation is completely different from normal Japanese, so it's really difficult.
That is definitely something that I have noticed quite a lot, especially in an area like Tokyo, people speak with a very monotone voice. But as soon as you get into the Kansai region, it's like this. It's like, hey, how are you doing? It's really wonderful here. And people always have such a almost a comedy in the way that they speak. So, it's cool that you picked it up, and I'm sure a lot of people didn't even realize that you weren't from the Kansai region. Because you have done it so well. I know I'm complimenting you way too much at the moment, but you do deserve it. So, is there a type of character that you haven't played yet that you'd like to play in the future, and you're just looking out for that role there? Is there something that you're really keen to do?
いろんなキャラクターをやらせてもらっているんだけど
I've tried a lot of different types of characters.
萌え
Like 萌え characters?
かわいいとか萌えかわいい子はない
I haven't really ever tried a 萌え character before.
Okay, that would be... Would you guys like to see that at some stage?
What's a 萌え?
Yes, good.
萌えキャラ?
But even though you haven't done it, is that something that you would like to do one day in the future?
Honey.
No.
Why do I get up? Thank you.
I'm not sure.
That's a very cool, that's a safe answer. Now I could sit up here all day and ask a lot of questions off you, but I'm sure there's some people out in the audience who would also like to ask a couple. Are you okay if I ask someone, if someone in the audience asks you a question?
Hi!
Yes?
Yes!
Okay. Now, I know you guys don't need much motivation to get up here, but there are some prizes that we have here which have been pre-signed and with a lot of love. Is there anyone out there who would like to ask a question? There's several out there. How about, is there someone out there who's dressed in a One Piece cosplay as well? Okay, the lights are shining right on you. Come on up on stage and I'll let you ask her a question.
Sanji-kun!
Okay, young man, what is your name?
It's Judy.
Not Sanji.
Okay, please come over.
Sanji-kun!
And take a seat here, please. Okay, so... You may now ask your question.
What's it like working with all the other One Piece debuts? Are you like off screen as well?
Nakama? Nakama desu.
No, we are nakama, we are comrades.
Totemo tanoshii desu.
It's a lot of fun working with them.
This is from my friend. She is asking, do you think Nami should end up with Sanji?
Judith?
Hi! Present for you.
Present.
Kirano, elande morao.
I think she told him to pick, I think.
On the table, there's a whole bunch of piles of gold and awesome shirts and some signed posters on here. So, which five do you want? I'm kidding, you only allowed one. This one?
Oh,
and do you want a signature on the front?
A Jolly Rogers, but with gold.
That was a joke. Okay, thank you, Judith. Give her a round of applause, please, everyone.